justifiable homicide. They tried to hide behind protocols, procedures, training. This was unacceptable. It took the mayor of this city 5 days before he responded officially to what happened to this young man. This speaks to a culture of cover-up. It speaks to a culture of lies and deception. But the community has spoken. We represent the sentiment of the community and the city and the citizenry of San Francisco who have called for this chief to either resign or be fired. This community has demanded that these officers who committed an act of murder be charged as such. We don't have to guess as to whether or not Mario Woods was murdered. He's dead. We don't have to guess about who killed him. It's on tape. Then the question becomes, is this justifiable homicide or was this outright murder? And that's something that the DA has to speak to, but the mayor has the direct power to speak to the question and the concern of this community that the chief be fired. This chief has resided over a climate and a culture of hate, bigotry, racism, sexism, a disregard for black life. We don't have to ask the question if black lives matter in San Francisco. It's obvious black lives don't matter in San Francisco. Here's a department that has rogue elements within it. Here's a department where officers have text messages where they have called for the taking down of animals, referring to black people. Those words prove to be pathetic, that a few years later, a young man treated like an animal was taken down. So this is not just some words, some musings, some joke from an officer that's text messaging. This speaks to a of San Francisco Police Department from the very beginning. Did you know that the San Francisco Police Department has its origin in vigilantism? It was the Committee of Vigilance, a vigilante group right in this city that morphed into what is now known as San Francisco Police Department. But they were vigilantes, hanging people, firing squads, murdering people. And then they morphed into the San Francisco PD, and the first chief was a leader of the vigilante movement. And it appears as if the POA wants to revive the origin of SFPD. That was vigilante justice that we saw on Third Street. That group was judge, jury, and executioner. And everybody has to speak to this. No silence, damn it. Those people in power have to speak to Mario Woods' murder. The board of supervisors have to take a position. The mayor has to take a position. The state attorney general has to take a position. The governor has to take a position. The lieutenant governor has to take a position. No silence today. Good police officers have to say to the world that the POA does not speak for us. Because if the POA's words are the only words that are speaking for the police department, then that means that all of you agree with the POA. According to the internal documents, the POA has asked its members not to cooperate with the DA's Blue Ribbon panel to discuss, to look at systemic racism in the department. And the POA and the mayor have joined together to warn the members of the police department not to cooperate with that Blue Ribbon panel. So that means you don't want reform. That means what you're doing is what you want to keep doing. And the people have said no more. It's either justice or else. I said justice or else.
Justice or else. blatant, most clearest example of police misconduct that we have ever seen on camera, where a young man was executed. If the city can't stand up in this instance, then that's a sign that this city will never stand up. So we're saying to the world, no more dark, dirty little secrets in San Francisco. Either you're a police department that protects and serves, or you're vigilante. And we've learned from the Police Officers Association that they've become experts at intimidation. They've become experts at smearing the good name of people who just want to question tactics and policy. Well, those days of intimidation are over. There's a group of us that want to challenge you at the highest level. So this is no time to shrink. And it's appropriate that we're at Christmas Eve and we're told the mayor got the hell out of town because he saw who was coming up to his office today. Well, you can run, as Joe Lewis said, but you can't hide. You are going to have to speak to this community. Chief Suhr has lost the right to lead this department. Any leader of any organization is studying trends. When you look at the trend all over this country of young black men being murdered by police, San Francisco should have been proactive. To look at what could we do differently here so that this doesn't happen in our city. But instead, they claim they have no tools other than beanbags or murder and nothing in between. Well, that's saying that the leadership of this city is unfit to lead an officer force to give justice and service to this community. Don't tell us you don't have any tools. These officers went through sensitivity training. I'm the former president of the African American Community Police Relations Board. I was part of the sensitivity training. I have spoken at the police cadets. I've spoken at their training center. So I'm not guessing. The problem is they accept the words in the academy, but when they get out on the street, another level of training takes place where the old veterans are schooling the young ones on how to deal with black and brown people. So this is no time to be afraid. You can stand up. And if you don't stand up, then stand out of the way and let those who are ready to stand up speak for you and speak for this community. So we're telling San Francisco on Christmas Eve, and we're telling the greater Bay Area, San Francisco is not a safe place for you to shop. Stay out of Union Square. You may get killed. Stay out of the shopping center. You may have a problem. In fact, we need to postpone Christmas. No more shopping. Let's break San Francisco. Make San Francisco suffer. Let's redistribute the pain that our community feels. Mario Lewis's mother's in pain. This community's in pain. And nobody seems to feel this pain. So we got to affect your pocketbook. Tell the people at Union Square, don't shop in San Francisco. Go to Walnut Creek. Go to Burlingame. Go to Palo Alto. Go somewhere else and spend your Christmas dollars. Stay the hell out of San Francisco. You may get killed walking down these mean streets. The mean streets of Union Square. The mean streets of Market Street. The mean streets of the Presidio. The mean streets of Pacific Heights. We don't know where you'll be killed in a city like this, where they can lie and cover up and make you believe Mario Wood threatened that officer, and that's why they shot him 40 times. This is a travesty. And Mayor Lee is not going to be able to stand by and be protected. We're going to dog your trail. Wherever you cut a ribbon, the community will be there demanding that you fire your chief. Thank you.
Together. Yes. We are together. Yes. We are coming together. We are standing together. And we are going to be together. Yes. We won't stop. We can't stop. The holidays are not important for us. The one thing that is important for us is justice. We're going to see justice through. We don't care if it's raining. We don't care if it's below zero. We don't care if it's snowing. We are going to stand until we see justice rain down on the black and brown community of San Francisco. We say, as a collective team, as Justice for Mario Woods Coalition, we say, sir, no, sir. We say no more executions in our community. We say, no, sir. We say justice for Mario Woods. I am Mario Woods. He is Mario Woods. We all are Mario Woods. And we are sick and tired of being sick and tired of being trampled on, being disrespected, being disposable, being not able to count. But we are here today, Christmas Eve. No shopping for us, because we are demanding justice. We are not asking, and we are not begging for justice. We are demanding justice. And so the next person I would like to bring up, because this is still a people's conference, a press conference. This is about the people. Robert Paul of DYTS, you want to come on up?
Yeah. Come on, Robert.
How you guys doing? My name is Robert Powell. I'm part of Discover Your True Self. It's a group that's designed to help 18 to 25-year-old men coming out of the incarceration thing. It's really frustrating to try to put a plan together to help guys mind the laws and do the things that are right when this type of stuff is happening. That brother was in a transition period of getting his life together, and he got swept down. Yeah. He got murdered. A lot of them been through college. A lot of them did well. We're from here. They're trying to put us out of here. This is bigger than Mario Woods. I actually didn't know Mario, but Mario is from my same neighborhood. I've been a negative person the majority of my life. The last 10 years, we turned it around. This murder made me step up. I don't want to bring extra attention to myself and get targeted by these police, but fuck them. You know, they're killing us. They're killing us. And they're getting away with it like it's nothing. I mean, I sat up and watched the beating last night. And that stuff that they address is, I mean, come on. This is our next generation. How are we supposed to put trust in these people? Right. You know, no justice, no peace.
No justice, no peace. No justice, no peace. No justice, no peace. No justice, no peace. No justice, no peace.
Okay, so we stand together, not only in the black community, but black and brown. And we have many organizations who are here supporting Justice for Mario Woods Coalition. The next speaker I would like to bring up is Ruthie from San Francisco Occupy. Occupy San Francisco.
Hey, everybody. Good morning.
Good morning.
You know, I don't have anything prepared, except I made a lot of signs last night. I am so upset as a mother.
Yeah,
I have seen some of the moms of these guys that have been killed, and it is outrageous. It ruins your whole life. You know, think about that for a second. That's someone's son. And, you know, I look around at the young black men that are coming forward for this, and I think it could be any one of them any day with this police department. It is horrifying to think of citizens getting shot down in the streets of our city that we trust, that we can walk around this city and think any minute that can happen. That is wrong. That is wrong. I want to hear some, that is wrong. Shame. Shame on them. Shame on them for killing people in the streets. And that's what I have to say. Thank you.
We want to bring up our next speaker, representing the longshoremen. No justice, no peace, no racist police. Brothers and sisters, I'm a third generation longshoreman. In 1934, San Francisco was the number one port city in the world. Maritime workers engaged in a coastwide strike for the right to have a hiring hall, collective bargaining, and living wages. In this city on July 5th, 1934, two strikers were killed. We memorialized that day by naming it Bloody Thursday. And every July 5th, we shut down all the ports on the West Coast to commemorate those two people who died.
Wow.
Let's be clear about who the police represent.
All right.
The police historically have represented capital.
Right.
Remember, the police department emanated from slave catchers. We need to be very clear that in terms of the role of the police in the black community, it is to control black bodies, protect property. We need to understand that labor, we're affiliated with the San Francisco Labor Council. We have unanimously voted that charges should be brought against those officers who murdered Reverend Mario. But let me explain something to you. These rallies and press conferences are fine. They serve a very important purpose. But if we are to expect some real change, we're going to have to engage in the kind of action that took place after those two maritime strikers were killed in 1934. There was a four-day general strike in the city of San Francisco. No movement of any cargo, no workers worked. This is not only a question of race, it's a question of class. Why is it that there's a double standard? Someone can go into a Planned Parenthood clinic, kill three people, and walk out. But why is it that a boy 12 years of age is shot down in cold blood, and right now the prosecutors are trying to let those cops off? The reason why we say Black Lives Matter is because they don't. All lives will matter when black lives matter. For those who stand by silently and think, oh, my son went to Harvard. Oh, my son goes to Catholic school. They are not immune. We have to understand, since we've been on these shores since 1619, we are the other. Why is it that a black woman who's homeless, who has an accident in Las Vegas, they want to say this was a terrorist act, but they would not declare a terrorist act when Dylan Roof in Charleston, South Carolina, killed nine black people in a church. I'm going to wind it up right now. Today I'm speaking as a rank-and-file of ILWU Local 10, we're calling for all longshoremen throughout the United States of America on May 1st, 2016, not to go to work. Calling for a national day of mourning for all black and brown people who have been murdered by the police who are unarmed. And I say to you, an injury to one is an injury to all. Thank you. And let's stay strong. Labor and the community united cannot be defeated. Let's say it. Labor and the community cannot be defeated. Thank you, brothers and sisters.
Next, we want to bring up...
A few years later, I was a co-founder of the Officers for Justice. I'm here today to speak as an individual. I'm here today to talk about tasers. Tasers is not the answer to the problem we're having today. I am here today to ask the mayor to please sit down with Officers for Justice and reconsider the use of tasers. You know, if five officers would have used their tasers on the day that Mario was killed, he would have, rather than died from bullets, he'd have died of electrocution. So our position in Officers for Justice is no tasers.
No tasers.
We want the use of shields. We can do a lot with shields. Tasers is not the answer. So, Mr. Mayor, Would you please sit down with the Office for Justice and reconsider the use of tasers? Thank you.
Give him a round of applause. The reason that position is so significant is because after 5 days of Mario Woods being murdered, the mayor came out not to speak to the issues of justice, but he said tasers are the answer. How dare you, as a mayor, give more tools to murder to a department that has already proven it doesn't know how to handle the weapons that it already has? No tasers? No, Chief Sir, because you've proven that you don't know how to train a department to give the adequate tools necessary to your officers to deal effectively and justly with the people of this city. Please receive our sister Felicia back to the roster.
Thank you, thank you. And so as the brother came up from the Longshoremen's Union, I would like to let the press know that Service Employees International Union Local 1021 is behind Justice for Mario Woods Coalition. We are calling out the unions. We are calling out not only the community, but the unions, because in your unions, there are members who live in the Bayview, and your members are also affected. So we want you to come and stand with us. So I am proud to be not only a delegate for Service Employees International Union Local 221, I am a union steward also. And so I am proud of Service International Local 1021 to make a stand. And the last time SEIU 1021 made a stand on Black Lives Matter and supported the resolution of Campos and Avalos, Supervisor Avalos, again, here is the POA. Here is Halloran writing a letter to our president telling her how out of line she is to support something like Black Lives Matter. Well, you know what? We have a lot of black lives in the unions. We are members. We are suffering. We care. We are hurting. And it is our responsibility. It is our duty to call all the unions out. If you have black members and we are paying dues, you need to be right here standing beside us. We are dues-paying members, and we count. Not only do we count in the community, but we count in your union. And so as I conclude right now, I want to bring Frank Williams up of SDOP.
My name is Frank Williams. Hello, family.
Hello.
We're no longer tired today. We're not tired no more. We're standing up today. Over 1,069 African-American men have been killed by the police department across the United States this year. Last year, over 1,200 was killed. The year before that, 1,100 was killed. When you saw yourself and witnessed Amadou Diallo getting 43 shots put into his body, reaching for a wallet. When you witnessed a Walter Scott running for his life and was shot down like a dog and was being set up with it, throwing something next to his body to say that he did wrong, but he didn't. That officer know he was caught on camera.
That's the only difference, the camera.
But right here in San Francisco, Mario Woods was executed. And it was caught on camera. Not only was it caught on camera, but our youth witnessed it. Our kids, our children witnessed that. There's post-traumatic stress running through our community because our community are being terrorized right here in San Francisco. A gunshot rang loud within the urban streets. A 26-year-old black male hits the concrete, and it sounded as if a 100-pound sack of potatoes hit the ground, and people were startled, and people were scurrying, and some people was running from, and some people was running to the scene where that crime took place. The scene where that young black male met his fate. He met his maker due to another whose misplaced hatred caused that young black male to lose his life. This misplaced hatred that caused the family left to grieve and cry, questioning, why, oh, why, my baby, a mother's cry. While those of us gathered around, questioning tears fell from our eyes. Not understanding how those that supposed to protect would come out here and kill us, you know.
Yeah.
The street life is speaking, and we ain't tired no more.
We are fighting for the freedom of the minority officers who work for law enforcement agencies across the United States, including San Francisco and the San Francisco Police Department.
Right. Yeah.
First of all, I want you to know that the Officers for Justice is concerned about their ability for our officers to be able to continue to recruit black males and females.
Yeah.
In the wake of the occurrences that specifically occurred, TexGate.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
The scandal has gone national, and it is embarrassing for those who continue to work tirelessly because we love the work that we do for the community that we serve. Also, I want to share with you that the San Francisco Police Association has shown that it has no problem misusing the resources of the members of our department. It bothers me gravely that they had no problem spending $300,000 of our union members' money to defend those who dared to engage in text games. It bothers me that the POA had the attorneys representing these officers state that they are seeking to be reimbursed for their legal defenses. It bothers me that the chief of police, or not just him, I would say the administrators at the time, failed to recognize and remember the police officer's procedural bill of rights, which gave them only 1 year to respond to this gross misconduct by officers who wear a blue uniform. It bothers me to think that they will be coming to stand somewhere near and about other officers of color and is serving the community, quote unquote. It bothers me that the environment that they are going to create may be unsafe, not only for me, because I'm an outspoken black woman, and I will always speak up for justice and freedom of those who cannot speak up for themselves. It bothers me that many of my members of the Officers for Justice are not here standing side by side next to me. It bothers me. It bothers me when my phone calls ring in the middle of the night with members of the Officers for Justice and members who are a minority of the San Francisco Police Department that tell me of the double standards that they are experiencing, not only in the wake of possible disciplinary actions, but also when they call to the POA and say, we need legal representation.
Right.
How dare you delay what is supposed to be recognized and part of your duty as a union? How dare you, the SFPOA, say that you speak for the minority officers and the minority communities? How can you speak for those you don't even know? It bothers me that the SFPOA continues to ring out with ads that say, we speak for the minority officers. We speak for the minority community. The fact that you give us $5,000 every 3 or 4 months to some nonprofit agencies within our communities does not give you the right to say you speak for the minority officers. You don't know me. You don't know my life. You are not even trying to understand how I live and survive in this community. How dare you, the SFPOA, and how dare you, road cops who engage in this tech gate, think that you deserve the right to wear the uniform that I spent all 26 years fighting to make sure that my star was never tarnished, and you dared to do it in the wake of TexGate. You dared to do it in the wake of the federal conviction. How dare you? you. I am just so disappointed this day. I rushed over here when I heard that there was going to be an opportunity to address the public. But you need to know, and you need to hold this bargaining agent, the SFPOA, and everyone else accountable to ensure that those officers, as Chief Greg Suhr has already committed to us and the mayor, never wear a blue uniform again that says SFPD. Power and freedom to my people. Power to the people.
And all of us need to stand behind Yolanda and any officer that speaks the organization. I came here and I fell upon the coalition by accident. I am a native San Franciscan. I've lived in the Upper Haight my whole life. I've called this place home. And I am here to call out one group of people who are destroying our town and are implicit in the death of Mario Woods, and that is the tech industry. While you open your app and you look for your rideshare car, remember that somebody somewhere in this city who is black or brown has been displaced, so you can rename our neighborhoods from the rich, historic Western Addition to NOPA. Remember, as you go to your sloppy bars and play beer pong, that someone is being brutalized by the police department so that you can take over their neighborhood. Get up and... You're not progressive because you moved here from Chicago 5 years ago and you do yoga. You need to participate in this city, full of diversity, rich in history. Black people built San Francisco. Black people built the Western Addition, not NOPA, the Western Addition. They built Upper Haight, and when people like Trump wanted to incarcerate Japanese people during World War II, the Japanese turned to the black people and said, protect my property. Because they knew that they built this city and they could count on them. And now we're being erased. We're being called unicorns. Oh my God, it's so great that you like are from here. You're like a unicorn. Wait, hold on, my Uber is here. Nobody cares about your Uber. We care about our lives. And you need to come and stand up with us. No more payroll tax breaks for Twitter as they push all these people out of the Tenderloin. Where are those people going to go? So that they can drink their $5 lattes with almond milk? Where are those people going to go? It's time for us to stand up for ourselves. And if the tech industry isn't going to stand with us, then they need to go back to Mountain View.
Solidarity for justice for Mario Woods. It is good that we're going to continue to shake the foundations in San Francisco until justice rolls down like the waters of a great and mighty stream. There will be no rest until those police officers are barred and charged for the crime they have committed against Mario Woods in the streets of Bayview Hunter's Point. And as we stand here in solidarity, brothers and sisters, look around you, you see your union brothers and your union sisters standing in solidarity. This is not a black thing. This is a true crime that has been committed against all mankind. So we're standing on the steps of City Hall this afternoon to shake the foundations to the mayor's desk, to tell Mayor Lee there is work that needs to be done eternally in San Francisco, California. It is time for us to stand and rise up from that dark, isolated valley and speak up with the true meaning, with a true meaning for all of God's children, for all of God's children, for all of your brothers and sisters who have lost their lives to police injustice. And it's not a coincidence that all of these young men happen to be black and the officers have to be white. That is not a coincidence. So we must, all of us, brown man, white man, yellow man, stand up in solidarity and stand up about what this country was built on. It says we hold these truths to be self-evident that all men were created equal. And those constitution was not only included for the white man, but it was included for the black man too. It was not only included for the black man, but it was included for the brown man too and the yellow man. So let's take this.
and put it on our shoulders and rise up, San Francisco, and bring these police officers to justice. Now is the time. Chief Suhr, we're reaching out to you to stand up on the truth for all of the unions that involve. Train some youth to become a painter. That's the bright side. Every time I see a cop gun down a young black, that's the slummy side. Carpenters, train some youth to become a carpenter. Now that's the bright side. We must rise up, unions, and come together as brothers and sisters and stand in solidarity. And preachers, pastors, you must pastor for life and not for profiteering on the death of young black men in your churches. Rise up today and stand up to the truth. We've always have had young black leaders in every generation. Minister Christopher, to stand up like the Moses of old. So today I stand up like the Moses of old, tell Mayor Lee, let my people go.
Nation, Baby Hunters Point Native. That means that my family goes back decades. My family helped build this city. They worked in the Navy shipyard. Several of my family members have died from cancer from living in Hunter's Point.
That's right.
The city is my city. The city belongs to black people of this city. There's a genocide being committed against black people. There has been a genocide being committed against black people since the days we were brought here in chains.
Yes.
Right.
That genocide is not just physical, it is mental, it is spiritual.
Yes.
They came with their Bibles and their guns and they enslaved us.
Yes.
Today we are still suffering from that enslavement. Though we don't see these physical chains, they are still there. We have shackles on our minds and our spirits. I represent the last 3% of San Francisco. The last 3% of black San Francisco is more like 2.4%. When you look at the statistic, they'll tell you it's 6%, but it's more like 2.4%. San Francisco has the fastest out-migration of black people since post-Katrina New Orleans. San Francisco has the fastest out-migration of black people since post-Katrina New Orleans. That was a natural disaster. This is a disaster that is happening here. A disaster. They are actively working, having meetings to eradicate us, to wipe us out. And that's because they know that we are gods. They have taken away our sense of agency. They have made our children believe that Europeans discovered this new world when we already have the world in our hands. So what they do when they murder us, they not only kill our children, they not only kill our brothers and our sisters, but they take away our history, they hide our history, they take away our spirituality, and so we don't have the ability to manifest things and fight for our power, fight for our right to be here, fight for our right to stay here. My brothers and sisters, they shut down the freeway yesterday with no fear. No fear, they shut down the freeway. And that's because this is not only about Mario Woods. This is not only about justice. Our lives are at stake here. So fuck a freeway. Our lives are at stake. Fuck getting arrested. Our lives are at stake. And what that means is that we cannot wait for a press conference. We cannot wait for a rally. We cannot wait for a march. We have to act every day. Act every day for justice for black people.
Yes.
Because the liberation of black people is the liberation of all people.
Yes.
So we need to continue to fight, continue to thrive, continue to educate ourselves, and divest from this capitalist system, and build our own pyramids, write our own hieroglyphs, and fuck shit up. We can't be dependent upon this system anymore. Power to the people.
Basically, how I feel is disgusted. I feel disgusted that every day our people is being persecuted. Our people is being murdered. Our people is being slaughtered and eradicated. Me personally, I've been put in the back of police cars for nonviolent things. I've been woken up at 3 in the morning to AKs and pistols in my face by the Oakland Police Department for a crime I had nothing to do with. I'm sick and tired of being treated like I'm an animal, like I'm less than human. I'm a human being. And I want all my people to know that they're human beings as well. I'm sick of all of our people being murdered on these streets.
And it's time for us to come together collectively and stand up for ourselves. Like my young righteous sister said in the back, our minds are being shackled, our spirits are being shackled, and we are being taught that we're inferior in all aspects of life. When we started this, we started civilization, and as she said, we had the world in our hands before anybody did. All right? So it's time for us to realize this, realize our self-worth, and come together and stand up for ourselves, because me personally, I'm sick of this shit, and I'm not going to take it no more.
And so as we come together, not only as a black community, but black and brown community, here is Mr. Roberto Hernandez.
Buenos dias. I brought my son here today because my son and I have been part of the Alex Nieto. You all know about Alex Nieto?
Yeah.
You know, what happened to Mario Woods ain't the first time it's happened here in San Francisco. It happened to Alex Nieto, and guess what? The mayor didn't do shit. The chief of police didn't do shit. The police commission didn't do shit. You know, nothing. You know, they talk about change. That's all they talk about for a minute. And let me tell you, if we don't stay together and work together as black and brown people, they will not do nothing. After Alex Nieto got killed, Perez got killed on 24th and Folsom. Do you know about Perez? Perez, brother Perez, a young brother, got killed on 24th and Folsom. And once again, we organized and demanded and nada, absolutely nada, ni caca pasa, nothing. Mayor Lee ain't done nothing. We've demanded of him. He don't even come out. But let me tell you, if it was some white boy in Pacific Heights that got killed by the police, you know where Mayor Lee would. If that would be Gavin Newsom's son or Pelosi's son, do you think that this police department will get away with murder? But that's what black people and brown people to them don't matter. And especially at a time like this, when it's all about gentrification. Like African Americans, look what they've done in the Mission. 10,000 people been displaced out of the Mission. They're trying to get rid of Latinos and African Americans out of San Francisco to make room for the rich white techies. That sister talked about that. So what do we got to do? We got to demand that the Mayor Ed Lee do something now. We got to demand that an outside investigation, because look what happened to the Alex Nieto investigation. Nothing. We need Obama and the federal government to come and do an outside investigation for not only words, but for Perez and for Alex Nieto. Cisa Perez!
Okay, and so as we come together, I want to also recognize the Honorable Louis Farrakhan and the Nation of Islam, who is showing leadership to Justice for Mario Woods Coalition. And so with the Nation of Islam and the Muslim community, I know we have some strong, strong backing here. And I just want to make sure that you guys know who is also part of Justice for Mario Coalition. So I'm going to bring up Keith Muhammad. Right. Keith Muhammad. Minister Keith Muhammad.
To the press, to the community at large, we stand before you because for 400 years we have not known justice. We question the fact that the government, whose steps we stand before today, have spent hundreds of years not providing justice for the poor, justice for the black, justice for the weak, and justice for others than a handful of class-driven people. So we stand here before the mayor and those here in city government and county government to say again that we're not satisfied by the decisions that they've made. In fact, we're not satisfied
by their failure to deliver justice in the suffering of the black man. Not only are we Mario Woods, there's a list of black victims so long that we'd be here for hours trying to recite who's been killed unjustly by law enforcement. So we say to the mayor clearly, sir, no, sir. We'll not any longer wait for you to do nothing. We're here before your office to make a demand because we know that power concedes nothing without a demand. So we bring power to the demand, and the power is the power of the unity of all of those that desire justice.
Yes, yes.
We're here in San Francisco. Millions of dollars are intended to be spent today. We follow the guide of the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, who is now asking that we spend not one dime. Boycott Christmas shopping. Let them not see one of your dimes before the new year. They don't understand right for the sake of right. That's why Thomas Jefferson trembled when he reflected that God is just, because his system is not. Our problem is not only the system. Our problem are the spiders that are spinning the web. That's why we say, sir, no, sir.
I definitely appreciate it, but I'm going to put this in a nutshell. I represent that 30%, that disenfranchised black man, that black man that I am and that you is, and we're speaking in the coalition of Mr. Woods. And on that term, I say, no, sir, to the chief, and I feel disgusted by this mayor. And I mean, all of us need to come together. My message is to the black man. We need to stand up, and we need to stand behind our elders. We need to stand behind the people who didn't put blood in for this community. And that's where I stand at in a collision. I haven't been able to eat. I haven't been able to sleep because I'm disgusted. And I am a part of a union. I'm a taxpayer. I am not a threat. But considering that we are considered to be a threat, we need to be a threat to this establishment and stand up for what we believe in, because we're going to stand for anything. So I stand for Mr. Woods. I stand for you, and I stand for upper standing, because right now I ain't understanding nothing.
Also, a representative from the Muslim community.
My name is Abu Qadir Al-Amin. I'm the leader of the Muslim Community Center, and I'm here in solidarity with Mario Woods.
Yeah.
And I wanna speak soberly. I can speak emotionally, but I don't think it would be as effective as me reminding you, every black and brown man in this audience knows the San Francisco police.
Yeah.
Not only do we know the San Francisco police, we know the Oakland police, we know the Chicago police, we know the New York police, we know the Miami police. It don't matter wherever we go, the police is a unified force that's abusing its power throughout the community all over America. We know that. And if it wasn't for the technology that we have today, we could all tell you our individual stories about injustice at the hands of police departments throughout America. We know they will lie. Sometimes they'll lie as something as minor as a traffic ticket. Why? Because they want your money. Sometimes they will steal. Had they not had cameras in those hotels on 6th Street, you wouldn't have seen the police stealing. And this is something that you have to know about criminal behavior. If you will lie, you will steal. It's a graduated process. Not only if you lie, you will steal. If you steal, you will kill. And we see that happening too much all over America. So what is the problem? I want to give you a spiritual, but also a material diagnosis of what the problem is. The police department is a cancer in America. And the cancer needs more than radiation. This is radiation right now. This is chemotherapy. Sometimes the cancer is so bad you have to cut it out. So what I'm saying is we have to cut out all of the corrupt elements in the police department. And those who support them, those on the police commission, who claim to admire men like Malcolm, No way would Malcolm take the position that some of the police commissioners have taken in being mealy-mouthed and mush-mouthed and protecting their paycheck and protecting their material interests instead of standing up for justice. And the police can lie good. You know, if they said Rodney King should have just stopped getting up, and we saw what that was. I have some personal experience as a 17-year-old. It took 17 police officers to put me in a car. And I ain't gonna sugarcoat it, they beat the shit out of me.
Yeah,
me too. All the skin peeled off my face.
Yeah.
Blood all over my shirt. And the police lied so good that had I not been there, I would have believed him. So this is the system that we're dealing with. We're dealing with professional liars. And we're dealing with a cancer in the human family where some people think they have a right and authority disregarding other people's humanity. And it's time to stop. So what are we going to do with the cancer? Cut it out. How are we going to cut it out? We can cut it out economically. We can diminish their budgets. So we can also petition the federal government to quit sending military style weapons to our community. And they're acting like we're all villains, we're all criminals. No, we're citizens and we demand our rights. And I need to say one more thing about the United States Constitution. And I'm going to be quick. It don't take a long time to say this. It's not a perfect document, so don't quote it like it's a perfect document. Why we got all them amendments? When you have to amend something, you're correcting it. Thank you very much.
No justice, no peace.
No justice, no peace. No justice, no peace.
people's voice that the mayor really didn't hear from the community most impacted by the murder. Mario Woods was our son.
About this time.